How's it going, everybody? It's finally time to make a full test drive video of my car. Out of popular demand, I'm finally getting around to it. It's a 2007 Lexus ES350 with the Ultra Luxury package. The first purpose is to do a full in-depth test drive, just like I do with any of my other videos, with the camera in the first person and the tripod position. And the second purpose is to demonstrate the recall that Lexus did for this a couple weeks ago that I got done at the local Lexus dealership. I'm going to show you exactly what they did and demonstrate how it all works and performs if you're driving down the highway. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Just a quick look-see. Now what they did first, they took the original all-weather mats that I bought with this car about 2 or so years ago, and they put a different design in. These are a little bit more shallow than the other ones. They got a different design. The old ones used to say Lexus, now they say Lexus ES. I kind of like that. Just kind of changes it up a little bit, but they'll replace this one and the one over there. The back ones will stay the same. And also, and this goes for the Camry too, and I don't know about any of the other models, they cut the pedal down just a little bit. They shave a little bit off the bottom and off the sides, and that's to prevent any incidences of floor mats in there getting caught. But if you have your floor mats installed properly, they will stay in there. There is absolutely no danger of them coming off. The only real incidence of that possibly getting stuck is if you have carpet mats underneath and you set this or some other type of mat on top of the carpet without bolting it in. That's the only way you can really kick it up in there. And I'm supposed to be getting in contact with Lexus towards the end of April, where they're going to have some redesigned pedals that are going to be available, so it doesn't have to be all chopped off, so you can inquire about that as you wish. But the main thing that they did is they updated the software of the car. And I'll go ahead and cut it on. Foot on the brake. It's got 37,000 miles. What they did, and I'll demonstrate that in a second, is if the car gets stuck in an open acceleration manner, you can hit the brake while you're going down the road and it'll cut the fuel to the engine. And also, you can, if you get the brake mashed down all the way to the floor, you can rev it all the way to the floor and it'll have like a little rev limiter. So let's go ahead and get started. Alright, the first thing I'm going to demonstrate is how the fuel cutoff system works. So, let's say you get stuck in an open throttle position. Hit the brake. See how quickly it stops? If I hold it again. See, I'm still mashing the pedal down. And it's staying where it is, but if I let off the brake, car will take back off. That way you can get it down to a safe speed if, God forbid, it ever got out of control. I personally am not that worried about it, but these fixes that they did are very reassuring that if something ever did get out of control, you'd be able to slow it down no problem. I'll do it one more time. Practically stops on a dime. And for the other thing, and don't quote me if this was on the car beforehand, but this is what was demonstrated to me. If the brake is pressed down, this is a stationary way of demonstrating pretty much what I just showed you. Brake is pressed all the way to the floor. You can floor the car. And that's all it'll stay. And once more. That's all it'll do. And obviously, if I let the brake off while you're doing that, you're gonna take off into oblivion, so to speak. All right, so let's get on with the test drive. Already got my tripod set up. I'm also going to demonstrate the manual shift mode and get out on the highway. I do have a ton of videos on this car on my channel, including demonstrations of all the navigation features and just overviews of the entire car and features of that, so be sure to check it out if you're interested. Fantastic sounding stereo. The car's factory system is a 14 speaker Mark Levinson premium surround system. And all I did with that sub is to just unplug the Mark Levinson sub and sub that in. Show the GPS.
The route guidance will start now. On the way to your destination, there will be roads with incomplete data. Turn-by-turn guidance will not be provided for these areas. Make a legal U-turn ahead.
After the beep, please say a command.
74 degrees.
Setting temperature to 74 degrees. After the beep, please say a command.
Radio.
Radio mode.
It's such a great sounding V6. And I'll do a quick demonstration of how the manual shifting works. Got it tilted down just a little bit so you can see that just a tad better. In first gear now. Very quick car. Oh, stoplight wood. Well, I guess this will be a good time to take it off real quick and do the first person.
Radio, there are no
also got the hands-free Bluetooth phone. Also different display settings. You get pretty good gas mileage. Most of my driving is steady driving. For a 270 horsepower engine, it's not bad at all.
After the beep, please say a command.
Automatic air conditioning.
Turning air conditioner off.
And thigh. Your choice fixin' and a made from scratch fix.
Well, hope you all enjoyed the tour and test drive and understand a little bit more about what they did with that recall. Oh, backing up failure. There we go. Perfect. Have a good one. And just in case nobody saw it in the other videos that I made for all the new subscribers, I have a custom dynamatted the entire back also. Where's the amp? I haven't put it on the back of the box yet. Yep, that's it.